Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. This is the Sunday of the Most Holy Trinity. We are baptized into the identity of the Holy Trinity. We sign ourselves with that identity. We greet one another in that identity, and we bless one another in that identity. But still, God remains a glorious mystery. We are constantly drawn to God through the love and mercy revealed in Jesus Christ. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary and the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
God our Father, who by sending into the world the word of truth and the spirit of sanctification, made known to the human race your wondrous mystery, grant us, we pray, that in professing the true faith, we may acknowledge the Trinity of eternal glory and adore your unity, powerful in majesty. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. The wisdom of God cries aloud. The Lord created me when his purpose first unfolded, before the oldest of his works. From everlasting I was firmly set. From the beginning, before earth came into being, the deep was not when I was born. There were no springs to gush with water. Before the mountains were settled, before the hills, I came to birth. Before he made the earth, the countryside, or the first rains of the world's dust. When he fixed the heavens firm, I was there. When he drew a ring on the surface of the deep, when he thickened the clouds above, when he fixed fast the springs of the deep, when he assigned the sea's boundaries, and the waters will not invade the shore, when he laid down the foundations of the earth, I was by his side, a master craftsman, delighting him day after day, ever at play in his presence, at play everywhere in his world, delighting to be with the sons of men. The word of the Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, by faith we are judged righteous and at peace with God. Since it is by faith and through Jesus that we have entered the state of grace, in which we can boast about looking forward to God's glory. But that is not all we can boast about. We can boast about our sufferings. These sufferings bring patience, as we know, and patience brings perseverance, and perseverance brings hope. And this hope is not deceptive, because the love of God has been poured into our hearts by the Holy Spirit which has been given us. The word of the Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, I have much more to tell you, but you cannot bear it now. But when he comes, the Spirit of truth, he will guide you to all truth. He will not speak on his own, but he will speak what he hears, and will declare to you the things that are coming. He will glorify me, because he will take from what is mine and declare it to you. Everything that the Father has is mine. For this reason, I told you that he will take from what is mine and declare it to you. The Gospel of the Lord. As I said, today we celebrate the Most Holy Trinity, a mystery of our faith. The problem with mysteries of our faith is that they're not like mysteries that you find in novels or in films, because of those situations you can pull together all the bits and pieces and finally come to a conclusion and realise what it all means. But often in the mysteries of our faith, we find the more we know, the more we realise how little we know. This in itself has some benefit, for in coming to discover that there is more we don't know, faith is called upon to express itself even more. And when faith becomes stronger, we come closer to God. The belief of our God being one person in three, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, has arisen from the Christian experience. The Apostle Paul touches on this experience a little in today's reading from Romans. Peace with God the Father, coming through the Son, and constantly being poured into our hearts by the Holy Spirit. These three persons have a role in the work of our redemption in the love of the one God. Jesus Christ also refers to this unique relationship in the Gospel. The Holy Spirit leads us into the truth which has been revealed in Jesus Christ as it has come from the Father. Now, I think we all are familiar with these thoughts. We might find it more difficult to try and explain it, though, to other people. In fact, we also notice that Jesus says that many things he has said to his disciples are too much for them to bear now. They are not going to get all the information. It is something they will be led into by the Holy Spirit eventually. But we are also those disciples who are still having more revealed to us in our historic journey. And we are those disciples whose faith must grow stronger because of what has not yet been revealed. It is a very difficult thing to comprehend. But there is a very good principle which is described to us in the first reading from Proverbs. Everything that God does is accompanied with wisdom. There is a purpose for what God does. The first reading absorbs us into the creating work of God, a work which continues to be our reality. God is always about creating. And at present, we are in the midst of this creation of a new heaven and a new earth. Everything God does has wisdom about it. We may not get it. It may well be too unfathomable for us, and we know that experience. Why, God, is such a common question in our lives? Why is there suffering? Why can't I get a job? Why does the world seem to be in such a mess? And so on. But the fact that not everything has been revealed to us is no reason to doubt that wisdom is a part of all God's activity and planning. That wisdom which created the world in the beginning has not ceased to exist, to be with God even now. This is certainly a step of faith for each of us to believe. It is a challenge, however, it is not a challenge foreign to the Christian experience. In fact, it is quite normal. In Romans, Paul says that we should boast about our sufferings. Sufferings bring patience. Patience brings perseverance. And perseverance brings hope. Hope is based upon our belief that God acts with wisdom. This hope was apparent at the crucifixion of Jesus Christ. It was apparent in the lives of the martyrs, and it is certainly apparent in the church of our modern world. That underlying belief that there is wisdom in what God does, despite the apparent lack of godliness in the world around us. It may be mystery, but at this table, real food and real drink is presented to us. At this table, real hope is offered in the midst of suffering, along with patience and perseverance. And at this table, our eyes begin to open to the truth. For here is the celebration of God's love for us. And as mysterious as that may seem at times, we can trust that there is wisdom in God's love for us. We confess our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten and not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With confidence, let us pray to our triune God, whom we worship as Father, Son, and Spirit, for our needs and for those of our church and world.
For the church, that she may be guided by the Holy Spirit and grow in wisdom and be faithful to the message of the gospel.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, we ask you to hear our prayer.
For nations, governments, and peoples of the world, may we recognize the sacredness of God's creation and work together for its proper use and protection.
Let us pray for the Lord.
Lord, we ask you to hear our prayer.
For all Catholics, baptized in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, may we be drawn into the very life of the Trinity by living lives filled with love and service.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, we ask you to hear our prayer.
For our society, may all foster an unfailing respect for human life, from natural conception to natural death.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, we ask you to hear our prayer.
For each of us, may we reflect the glory of God's presence in our community, in all our deeds.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Glory to you, hear our prayer.
For
may they live forever, sharing the life of the Blessed Trinity.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Glorious to hear our prayer.
Eternal Triune God, pour forth your love into our hearts and keep us ever faithful. Hear these prayers we make, that we might one day enjoy everlasting life with you. We make these prayers through Christ your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Sanctified by the invocation of your name, we pray, O Lord our God, this oblation of our service, and by it make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere we give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For with your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord, not in the unity of a single person, but in a trinity of one substance. For what you have revealed to us of your glory, we believe equally of your Son and of the Holy Spirit. So that in confessing of the true and eternal Godhead, you might be adored in what is proper to each person, their unity in substance and their equality in majesty. For this is praised by angels and archangels, cherubim too and seraphim, who never cease to cry out each day, as with one voice they have played.
Thank you.
holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance of your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints of his constant intercession in your presence, we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation be praying, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Mark, our Bishop, and his assistants Brian and Joseph, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your home. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family if you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, to whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word of my soul. Let us pray. May receiving the sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul, as we confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity through Christ our Lord. Amen. We must acknowledge the enhancement of music here this morning with the strings. I don't even know your story or who you are. I don't imagine that James Jody Busking in the Queen Street Portland gave an offer you couldn't refuse. But you're most welcome to thank you for this morning. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.